युवनेतां ख्लादेकमयीम् अनन्यपरतन्त्रां नवरसरुचिरां निर्मितिम् आदधति भारती कवेर्जयति. वी डिड् टिल् व्याजस्तुति लास्ट् वीक्, स्वभावोक्ति अण्ड् व्याजस्तुति. नौ सहोक्ति अण्ड् विनोक्ति. सह उक्तिः विना उक्तिः, बोत् आफ् दीस् आर् इम्पार्टेण्ट् इन् द सेन्स् ओन्ली इफ् इट् गिव्स् ए चमत्कारम्. इफ् इट् इस् जस्ट् पुत्रेण सह पिता गच्छति, देर् इस् नो चमत्कारत्वं देर् and there is nothing. So where two things which cannot go together are expressed as together with the words saha, etc. So that is saha uktihi. So sa sahoktihi sahartasya balat ekam dvivachakam. Sa sahoktihi saha arthasya बलात् एकं द्विवाचकम्. सो एकार्थ अभिदायकम् अपि सहार्थबलात्, ईवन् दो देर् इस् जस्ट् वन् मीनिङ्ग् टु इट्, सः अर्थबलात् वि यूसिङ्ग् द वर्ड् सः, उभयस्य अवगमनम्. सो देर् इस् वन् मे बि गुणं क्रिया संथिङ्ग् आर् दि अदर् आर् दट् इस् अटाच्ड् टु टु आब्जेक्ट्स् एण्ड् यूसिङ्ग् द वर्ड् सः दे वे बि टोटलि डिफ्रेण्ट्. Yet he uses the word saha along with to express that these two are similar. The example is saha divasa nishabihi dirghaha shwasadandaha saha mani valayehi bashpadhara galanti tava subaga viyoge tasyaha udvignayaha sahacha tanulataya durbala jivitasha. He subaga तव वियोगे सति तस्याः उद्विग्नायाः श्वासदण्डाः दिवसनिशाभिः सह दीर्घाः. सो सो फस्ट् वन् इस् दिवसनिशाभिः सह श्वासदण्डाः दीर्घाः. दिस् इस् अ डिस्क्रिप्शन् आफ् अ नायिका हू इस् इन् विरहम् एण्ड् सो द सखी इस् डिस्क्रैबिङ्ग् द नायिका विरह टु द नायक. हे सुभग तव वियोगे सति, बिकास् शी इस् सेपरेटेड् फ्रम् यू, तस्याः नायिकायाः उद्विग्नायाः, शी इस् सफरिङ्ग्, पीडितायाः तस्याः श्वासदण्डाः. श्वासदण्ड मीन्स् अनवरत श्वासम्. शी इस् कान्स्टेण्ट्लि गिविङ्ग् औट् लाङ्ग् ब्रेथ्स् लैक् सैज़्. सो शी इस् सैङ्ग् कान्स्टेण्ट्लि निःश्वासाः. दे आर् दीर्घाः, लाङ्ग् ब्रेथ्. She is letting go of long breath and her breaths are very long, just like divasa nishabihi. Not just like, the expression he uses is along with day and night, her shwasa danda, shwasaha api dirghaha santi. Now here, shwasa is actually directly shabdaha. Dirgha. Okay, let me explain that later after we understand the shloka. Otherwise, it's going to confuse. So, the expression here is, vachyartham here is, shwasadandaha, tasyaha shwasadandaha, her breaths are long, dirghaha, along with divasa nishabihi, along with the day and night. Bhashpadhara galanti, tasyaha bhashpadhara, her flow of water, tears, bhashpadharaha, manivalayaihi saha galanti. Her tears slip along with her bangles. She's wearing bracelets. She's become so thin that the bracelets just slip away from her hand. Just like how tears automatically slip. She doesn't make an effort to cry. It just automatically, her eyes tear up and the tears just slip away from her eyes. They just fall down. Bhashpadharaha manivalayaihi saha galanti. तस्याः तनुलतया सह जीवित आशा दुर्बला. जीवित आशा, हर् विल् टु लिव्, हर् डिसैर् टु लिव्, जीवित आशा दुर्बला, हेस् वीकेण्ड् अलाङ्ग् वित् हर् बाडि. तनुलता, क्रीपर् लैक् बाडि. सो हर् बाडि हेस् आल्सो वीकेण्ड् एट् द सेम् टैम् हर् लैफ् इट् डस् नाट् नीड् द सपोर्ट् आफ् द तनुलता फर् द जीवित आशा टु बिकम् दुर्बलम्. There is no such sahartham necessary here. But balat ishyate. Forcibly, you are putting two objects together and saying, janulataya saha jivita asha durbala jata. So along with her body, her will to live has also weakened. श्वासदण्डाधिगतं दीर्घत्वं दीर्घत्वादि शाब्दं दिवसनिशादिगतं तु सह अर्थ सामर्थ्यात् प्रतिपद्यते. हियर् श्वासदण्डाः दीर्घाः जाताः हेस् बीन् एक्स्प्रेस्ड् डैरेक्ट्ली इन् प्रथमाविभक्ति. करेक्ट्, श्वासदण्डाः दीर्घाः जाताः, सो दट् इस् अ शाब्द अन्वयः. दिवसनिशाः अपि दीर्घाः जाताः. That if you use divasa nishabihi dirgaha, there is no anvaya siddhi there. You can't say because of with nisha and so it's actually the literal meaning is nisha and night and day have also become long because of the viraham. She is not able to go through the days and nights seem very long for her and she cannot tolerate that because of the viraham. That is the idea here. So divasa nishahanamapi dirghatvam atra artha samartya deva bhavati anvayaha natu sakshat shabda anvayaha. You can do it only based on with the presence of the word saha there. Divasa nishabihi saha dirghaha jataha, it only connected with the saha can you go to dirghatvam. Otherwise there is no direct connection by shabda between divasa and dirgha. Okay, I hope it's clear. In the same way, if you look at the next one also, bashpa dharaha galanti. So that galanam, that is direct here. So bashpa dharaha galanti mani valayani api galanti parantu tatra sakshat anvayaha nasti. Mani valayehi is in tritiya vibhakti and galanti is in direct kartari kriyapadam. So they both cannot, there cannot be an anvayam. So saha samarthyat, saha iti padasya arthasya samarthyadeva manivalayaha ityasya viti shabdasya galanti galanakriyaya saha anvayaha bhavitum arhati. The same way tanulataya durbala jata, you cannot have that. So tanulataya saha jivita asha api durbala. So jivita asha is directly connected, whereas tanulataya saha, it uses saha to get connected to durbala. Okay, this is sahokti. Now the opposite, vinokti, without something. You're saying with along with something, and now it is the opposite here. Vinoktihi sa vina anyena yatra anyaha sanna na na itaraha. To get the karika properly, anyena vina, get the anvayam proper. So anyena vina yatra anyaha sanna na. So anyena vina anyaha sanna na iti prathamam. The next you take the same words and instead of na you'll have to take just na itaraha. So anyena vina anyaha sanna na itaraha. So what is that ekaha? What is the itaraha? Ekaha tu shobhanaha, the other one is ashobhanaha. Okay, how does it become so? When one is absent without another, so this thing becomes, does not look good, or it looks good even without the presence of another thing. So two things have to be together. Like for example, night and the moon have to be together, full moon have to be together always for both to be beautiful. If one is absent, if one is without the other, then it doesn't look good. That is ashobhanatvam. Even if one is absent, so even if I don't have the association of a bad person, I am better off without the association of a bad person. So that is, I am better. So shobhanatva pratipadanam. So without something, if you are describing the beauty of someone, that is the first type of vinokti. If you are describing that something is, or that is the second one actually. So kenachid kasyachid ashobhanatvam, kenachid vina kasyachid ashobhanatvam yadi varnitam tarhi tatra prathama. First type of vinoktihi. Dvitiya vinoktihi kenachid vina kasyachit shobhanatvam yadi varnitam. So kachit ashobhanaha, kochit shobhanaha. Kramena udaharanam. Aruchihi nishaya vina shashi, shashina sapi vina mahattamaha, ubhayena vina manobhava spuritam naiva chakasti kaminoho. the night should always be with the moon. If it is without the moon, or if the moon is without the night, so in the morning you have the moon, there is Arunodayam is also happening on the other side. The moon also exists sometimes, but the moon will not look so beautiful. Even if it is the full moon, it is not going to look beautiful unless it is connected with Nisha, night. So Nishaya Vina, without night, Shashi, the moon, Aruchihi, it is not so beautiful, it is not attractive. Shashina Vina Sa Abhi, Shashina Vina, without the moon, Sa Abhi, the night too, Mahattamaha. I think that Mahattamaha should go to this Shashi. Mahattamaha Shashi, Mahattamaha Aruchihi it should be. Sorry, it is Mahat Tamaha. Mahat Utkatam Tamaha Andakara Rupa Eva Sa Nisha Abhi. Shashina Vina, without the moon, Nisha Api, Andhakara Rupa Asti, she also becomes engulfed in darkness without the moon. Ubhayena Vina, if both are absent, the moon is also not there, the night is also not there, the Kama Spuranam between lovers is not going to be as beautiful like in nighttime, right? It's not going to be beautiful during the day. It doesn't have that same charm as it does during the night and during moonlight. So, Ubhayena Vina, without Nisha and Shashi, Ubhayena Vina, Kaminoho Manobhava Spuritam Naiva Chakasti. The flame of love between lovers, Manmatha spark between lovers, is not Na Chakasti, Naiva Chakasti, it is not so beautiful. So kena chit vina nishaya vina kasya chit shashinaha ashobhanatvam atra pratipadita tatha shashina vina nishayaha ashobhanatvam shashi nishabhyam vina manobhava spuranasya ashobhanatvam api pratipadita. Okay, next is shobhanatva pratipadanam. Mrigalochanaya vina vichitra vyavahara pratibha prabha pragalbhaha amrita dyuti sundarashayaha ayam suhrida tena vina narendra sunuhu. Tena is very important. Narendra sunuhu, a prince who is young and is in his youth, but he is not attracted towards any woman. So mrigalochanaya vina, without the distraction of love, without the distraction of any woman, Mriga Lochanaya Vina, without a woman by his side, Vichitra Vyavahara Pratibha Prabha Pragalbaha Saha Narendra Sunuhu. This prince is able, is an expert, Pragalbaha, in showing creativity, Pratibha Prabha, in showing creativity, or in that spark of Pratibha, in the spark of creativity, he is an expert. And he does vichitra vyavahara. He does a variety of works. You can multitask when you don't have any distractions. You don't have any responsibilities. You can do n number of things in your day, right? So here he says, mrigalochanaya vina, in the absence of a lady, this prince is an expert in doing astonishing or a variety of creative works. The second one, it also adds another thing. Tena suhrida vina. Tena suhrida ityukte tadrisha suhrit vina. Kidrishaha khalaha. So you understand it as dushtaha. Without that sort of a bad friend, this person's ashayaha, hridayam, this prince's hridayam is sundaram. It is very beautiful and like an amrita dyuti, like the nectar. Okay, so in the absence of that bad friend, his heart is also as beautiful as, Amrita Dyuti is moon. So Amritam Dyutihi Kiranam. So Amrita Kiranaha is moon. His heart is also very beautiful like the moon. So without the influence of a bad person, a prince can lead a very, he can be at pure at heart. And without the influence of a lady, or without the distraction of Vishaya Asangaha Yadi Nasti, then he can perform so many different varieties of work, and he can be more responsible in the kingdom. ओके सो हियर देर इज अ शोभनत्वम् मृगलोचनया विना नृपसूनोः शोभनत्वं प्रतिपादितं तथैव दुष्ट सुहृत् विना तस्य हृदयस्य शोभनत्वम् अत्र प्रतिपादितम् ओके वर्णितम् दिस् इस् विनोक्ति नेक्स्ट् इस् परिवृत्ति अलङ्कार इस् अ वेरि स्वीट् वेरि क्यूट् अलङ्कार इन् द सेन्स् इट्स् अबौट् जस्ट् एक्स्चेञ्ज् आफ् थिङ्ग्स् बिट्वीन् टु पीपल् सो परिवृत्तिः नाम विनिमयः द वर्ड् इट् सेल्फ् मीन्स् विनिमयः आर् एक्स्चेञ्ज् यः अर्थानां सम असमैः स्यात् अर्थानां सम असमैः विनिमयः परिवृत्तिः अलङ्कारः स्यात् बिट्वीन् आब्जेक्ट्स् इफ् देर् इस् अ बार्टर् सिस्टम् रैट् इट्स् एन् एक्स्चेञ्ज् आफ् आब्जेक्ट्स् रैट् इफ् यु हेव् द टैम् यु शुड् लुक् एट् वाट् मै फ्रेण्ड् हेस् सेड् इन् द channel there is a parivritti alankara but it is in tamil you can see if you can understand something so I'll try to explain that also here if possible so samena samasya uttamena nyunasya nyunena uttamasya so three types of parivritti alankara is there samena sama I give you something and you give me something of the same value then that is fine उत्तमेन न्यूनस्य ऐ एम् गिविङ्ग् यू समथिङ्ग् ग्रेट् सोरि उत्तमेन न्यूनस्य परिवृत्तिः समवन् इस् गिविङ्ग् समथिङ्ग् वेरि लेस् एण्ड् गेटिङ्ग् बेक् अ ग्रेट् थिङ्ग् इन् रिटर्न् आर् उत्तम नो नो ऐ थिङ्क् दिस् इस् आपोसिट् सो उत्तमेन न्यूनस्य विनिमयः मीन्स् विनिमयः इस् डिस्ट्रिब्यूशन् सो न्यूनस्य विनिमयः कनेक्टेड् वित् देट् सो यु गिव् बेक् something which is lesser in value for something greater that you take so uttamena uttama vastu grihitam atra nyunasya vinimayah kritah you exchange it for something lesser and then the third type is nyunena you take something very less and yet you give back a lot so uttamasya vinimayah the first example is for the both 1 and 2 samena samasya अण्ड् उत्तमेन न्यूनस्य लतानाम् एतासाम् उदितकुसुमानां मरुदयं मतं लास्यं दत्त्वा श्रयति भृशम् आमोदसमम् आमोदम् असमं लतास्तु अध्वन्यानाम् अहः दृशमादाय सहसा ददत्याधिव्याधिभ्रमि रुदितमोहव्यतिकरम् लतानाम् एतासाम् एतासां लतानाम् उदितकुसुमानां भृशम् असमम् आमो लास्यं दत्त्वा मरुत् अयं भृशम् आमोदम् असमम् आददाति श्रयति मीन्स् स्वीकरोति द विण्ड् गिव्स् अ ब्यूटिफुल् डान्स् टु द क्रीपर्स् सो बिकास् आफ् द ब्लोयिङ्ग् आफ् द विण्ड् द क्रीपर्स् डान्स् सो मतं लास्यं दत्त्वा मतं सुन्दरं लास्यं दत्त्वा सो अयं मरुत् दिस् विण्ड् gives a beautiful dance to the creepers and then what does it take from the creeper it takes the fragrance from those creepers which have kusuma udita kusuma so it has fully bloomed flowers and from those flowers of the creepers etasam latanam udita kusumanam asamam amodam a unique fragrance there is nothing anupamam amodam gandham brisham shrayati it takes a lot of fragrance from these flowers of the lata after giving it a beautiful dance so the exchange of things have happened here so the marut gives lasyam and that is also beautiful and it takes the fragrance from the lata which is also beautiful so there is an exchange of equal things between the two the next line lataah now in turn what does this lata do it gives a beautiful fragrance to the marut now this whole thing is like a description of shrungara uddipakam so there is a sweet breeze that is going on there is a very sweet smelling breeze that is there the creepers also are very attractive with flowers those who are all traveling on the road will look at these creepers which are very beautiful so what do they provide their attention to the creepers what do the creepers give in turn they give aadhi vyadhi brami rudita moha vyatikaram vyatikaram is aapat so they give all sorts of trouble to the travelers because they are separated from their wives they have come on business they're looking at the spring season and the beauty of the lata. Instead, the lata is only giving them virahatapam. Lataha tu sahasa. Immediately, what does these creepers do? Advanyanam drisham adaya. Advanyanam drisham adaya. It takes the sight of the travelers. That is, it gets the attention of the travelers, which is, it is showing off something, right? So that attention is actually something greater than the suffering that this lata gives back. Adhi is manovyatha, mental suffering, mental pain. Vyadhi, physical pain, because they feel fatigued immediately. When they look at all this, they're not able to enjoy it. So immediately they feel very fatigued. Brahmi, they're dizzy. Rudita, they start crying because they can't go and meet their lover. Moha, some people faint and they don't know what to do. These are all the different changes that happen to them. Dadati, this which is given by the Latha. The next one is, Nanavidha Praranaihi Nripa Samprahare Svikritya Daruna Ninadavataha Praharana Driptari Veera Visarena Vasundhareyam Nirvipralambha Parirambha Vidhir Vitirna. Nanavidha, hey Nripa, Dripta Arivira Visarena Samprahare Nanavida Praharanaihi Praharana Svikritya. So all these enemies, what they do is they get so many beatings from you. Nanavida Praharanaihi Daruna Ninadavataha Praharana Svikritya. Praharana Svikritya. They take so many hits from you. They get hit by you in the battlefield. Samprahare Yuddhe. Praharanam means praharanam is ayudham and praharaha is beating. So dripta ari veera visarena. Where is this? Ayaha dripta darpayukta shatru samuhena. Prahare, Vitirna. So that Dripta Arivira Visarena, Dripta arrogant Arivira enemy soldiers or enemy courageous people, the Viras, Visarena, Samuhena, Vasundara Vitirna. They give the entire earth to you in exchange for beatings. So they get beat by you and they, in turn, they give the entire earth to you. So, tena, shatru samohena, vasundhara datta. Katham, praharana svikritya. Bhavataha praharana svikritya, vasundhara vitirna. Now, the adjectives are all like this. So, samprahare in the battlefield. The group of enemies, arrogant enemies, dripta arivira visarena, Nanavidha Praharanaihi, with the help of different types of weapons, Daruna Ninadavataha, when they hit also, you know, it is very cruel to hear. The sounds that come out of the weapons are very cruel. So they get beat along with sounds which are very cruel to hear. A simple tap is different from a slap. So the sounds are so much more cruel than a small tap, right? So Daruna Ninada Dhvani Vataha. So those beatings, Praharana Svikritya, taking the beatings which have a very cruel sound, Yam Vasundhara, this earth, which is Nirvipralambha Vidhi. There is no way you're going to be separated from this Bhumi. Tadrishim bhumim te they gave, really, correct. Vitirna means distribution is the literal meaning, but here you take it as the datta. So vasundara taihi shatrubihi nirviprlamba vidhihi vasundara. This is an adjective to vasundara. So in such a manner that this earth is never separated from you, you will always be the ruler, and they have given you the sovereignty which is greater. So uttamasya vinimayaha atra kritaha kena nyunena. So praharana svikritya vasundhara dittam. Right? So very nice verse written by in Kovalyananda. Also, there is a very nice verse, and that is where Jatayu, he protects Sita, but he gets moksha instead. So by giving in exchange for protection, he got moksha actually. See, Rama, Sakshat Rama comes and does Antima Samskaram for Jatayu. A beautiful shlokam. I don't
Oh,
remember.
even this is very good, Akka. Even that, when you're explaining, you know, I can imagine how beautifully they must have described that shloka.
And she also includes one Tamil where Avayar, Avay party, she starts off with one verse to Pullayar, Ganesha. She says, I will give you in a bowl, I'll give you palum, tenum, pagum, parpum. So I'll give you jaggery, tain, honey, milk, and everything for Naivedyam. And then you have to give me all the three types of Tamil, which is Iyal, Isai, Nadagam. Both, poetry, prose, and drama, and everything, all the different varieties of literature you give me.
Oh, very cute.
So here, but she'll wonder, she'll ask me, is it samena samaha or uttamena uttama, nyunena uttama? You can't say, because in return for all that literature, she is giving ananya bhakti to him. So
Oh,
which is greater here? You can't even decide, no?
yeah.
Every time we light the lamp at the God, we say this one thing in Tamil. No, give me a shed full of horses, give me a box full of bhushanam and all that. I'm lighting this little lamp in front of you. Give me a big house, give me children, all of these things. And then at the end, we also say, Yellam tandenyan pakkathil nillum amma. Don't go away after giving all of this. Come and stand near me always.
Oh.
So you just light one small lamp and ask for so many things from her, huh?
Oh. Very nice.
I know, this is a very beautiful, cute alankara. Okay, next one is bhavikam pratyakshaiva yad bhavaha kriyante bhuta bhavinaha bhutasya athava bhavinas bhavi bhavinaha padarthasya pratyaksha iva. You are trying to describe something which has happened before as if it is in front of you, or something that is going to come in future, you are describing it as if it is in front of you. So pratyaksha iva bhavaha bhavaha ityukte padarthaha. So bhavaha athava kavehe abhiprayaha. Whatever the poet wishes to say, those padarthaha bhutaha athava bhavinaha. So bhuta bhavinaha pratyakshaiva yadi kriyante yadi varnyante tatra bhavikam nama alankara. Bhutascha bhavinascha iti dvandvaha dvanda samasa, that is. So bhavaha meaning kavehe abhiprayaha atra asti iti. That is kavehe abhiprayaha pratyakshaha bhavaha. The poet wishes to convey that anything that is in the past or in the future is as if it is present in front of our eyes. Most of the times, the poet, when he describes, it is like as if it has come in front of us. Whether it is just words on paper or the power of expression is such that. But even there, if he directly expresses the fact that I see something which is not something which is in the past, or I see something which is going to be in the future, then it is. The example makes it more clear. Asid anjanam atreti pashyami tava lochane bhavi bhushana sambharam sakshat kurve tavakritim. Simple shloka. Atra tava lochane, in your eyes, I see your atra anjanam asit iti tava lochane pashyami. Atra, here you had worn that kajal. There was kajal before iti tava lochane pashyami. I am looking at your eyes now as if it had before that it had an anjanam before. So in a sense, he is looking at it. He is imagining how that eye would have been, her eyes would have been with kajal, and how beautiful it would have been. So he is imagining that as pratyaksham. Atra anjanam asit iti tava lochane adhuna pashyami. That is pratyakshamiva pashyami. That is what it means. So bhuta anjanam abhut iti vishayam atra pratyakshataya abhidanam. I see that it was there. So that is a bhavikalankara. Bhavinaha, what is going to be in future? Bhavi means future. So bhavi bhushana sambharam sakshat kurve tava akriti. Tava akritim sakshat kurve. I am seeing your form as if how it would be if you were decked with bhushanam later. So bhavi in future, bhushana sambharam, when you are wearing the wealth of alankaras, how your form would be, tat tatham akritim sakshat karomi. I'm viewing it. See, sometimes I imagine how it would be if, you know, our house was decorated like this, or my child was decorated like this, something, you know, we imagine so many things in it. But if he describes it like that, as if he sees it, sakshat kurve means I see it in front of my eyes. So it is being described as something present in front of his eyes. Okay, so adhye bhutasya, dvitiye bhavinaha darshan. So this is two types of bhavikam. Both are presented in the same alankara. I'm going to stop with this.